Dr. S. Revathi is working as an assistant professor in Anna University, Chennai. She obtained her UG degree from Stella Maris College, PG Applied Chemistry from College of Engineering, Anna University. She has completed her PhD at the Department of Chemical Engineering, AC Tech, Anna University. Her main areas of research are focused in tailoring and characterizing the porous materials and its application in catalysis. To her credit, she has published 7 papers in national and international peer-reviewed journals of high repute. She has presented more than 15 papers in international and national conferences. She has more than 13 years of experience in both teaching and research. She has handled organic chemistry for more than 6 years for both UG and PG classes.
Welcome to UGC lecture series on polymer science. On today's lecture, we will be discussing the part 2 of stereochemistry under the following contents. We will define what is chiral, what is achiral, what is the difference between chiral and achiral, what are the criteria for chirality, and how symmetry and chirality plays role in stereochemistry, and then what is asymmetry and what is dissymmetry, what is stereogenic center and non-stereogenic center, and finally we'll discuss about enantiomers and diastereomers. So what is chiral? In order to explain chiral, we would take the best example of our hands. If you see the right hand and left hand, both are not superimposable. Suppose if I place my right hand next to the mirror, what is the image that I produce is the left hand. Similarly, if I place my left hand next to a mirror, and what I produce in the mirror is my right hand. So at any point, both the hands are not going to be superimposed. So here we could see the observation, it is not being superimposed. So this is what is meant by chiral. Chiral means, in Greek word, it means handedness, which means both left hand and right hand are not superimposable. So which is given in this picture, see the left hand and you have a mirror placed, and you have a right hand, both are non-superimposable mirror image. So the first important point to note about chiral is a molecule or object that is not superimposable on its mirror image is said to be chiral. So we define chiral object as one that has right and left handed forms, and it forms non-superimposable mirror images, and it should have asymmetric center. What is asymmetric center now? An atom is chiral, or asymmetric center is a center that has 4 different groups attached to it. See, well, we are giving an example for chirality with respect to chemical molecules. Here we assume the carbon, and these are the 4 different 1, 2, 3, 4 numbers are given. All these 1, 2, 3, 4 groups are of different, we have differentiated with the colors. So this carbon is being attached to 4 different groups, and when you place a mirror image, you get the mirror image of this molecule, not the original molecule. So the original molecule, if I place it above this mirror image molecule, both are not identical. So this is the example to show a chiral present in a molecule. If I place carbon here and all the 4 atoms are to be similar, in the case of methane, if you take the structure of methane for example, we take methane. Methane is being surrounded by 4 hydrogen atoms in regular tetrahedron fashion. So you could see all the 4 atoms are similar. So when I draw a mirror image for this methane molecule, you get identical molecule with respect to this mirror image. So these are identical with respect to each other, hence this molecule cannot be a chiral one. So this is to show you how a chiral molecule gets differed from an achiral molecule. So now we will start with what is chiral molecule. A chiral molecule with 1 chiral center is chiral molecule. A chiral molecule with more than 1 chiral center is achiral. note if it is an achiral molecule, what you need to observe is whether it has got a plane of symmetry or not. Achiral molecules, moreover, it will not be an optically active one, which means it cannot rotate the plane polarized light in equal magnitude and in opposite direction. So, this is the example to show you achiral molecule. So, we take the example of water molecule, oxygen, and it is being linked with two hydrogen atoms. Here we place a mirror, and suppose if I place the same molecule over this, here we have placed both the molecules, the bonds and atoms align each other, and now this molecule is said to be not a chiral one, it is a achiral one. So, achiral versus chiral. For example, if we take the example of bromochloromethane, as I told you, plane of symmetry is very important to determine whether the molecule is chiral or achiral. So, here if you see carbon and two hydrogen atoms are lying beside, one is bromine, assume we will take this as bromine and this as chlorine atom. So, if I pass a plane over here, I get the reflection of this hydrogen atom over here, which means this cannot be a chiral one, and moreover this carbon is not being bonded with four different atoms, because here you have the same kind of atoms present. So, this molecule has two identical halves when you cut it. So, this CH2BrCl is an achiral molecule, whereas if I replace one hydrogen atom with fluorine atom, assume this as carbon and this as hydrogen and this as fluorine and this as chlorine and this as bromine. Now, this carbon is being connected to four different atoms, and if I cut this molecule or if I pass a plane, so it is not going to give two identical halves. So, this is called as a chiral molecule. Hence, we can conclude finally, achiral molecule will have a plane passing through it and it will cut into two identical halves, whereas chiral molecule, it does not have a plane of symmetry. So, we define the achiral molecule as it has identical mirror images, either it should have no stereogenic center or more than one stereogenic center, and it should possess symmetry of elements. For example, if we take 1, 2 dimethyl cyclobutane, both cis and trans form. So, in order to explain the plane of symmetry, we take the example of cis 1, 2 dimethyl cyclobutane. So, this is the structure of 1, 2 dimethyl cyclobutane. You have methyl position substituted at 1 and methyl position substituted at 2 position. If I pass a plane on this molecule, the part of methyl is being reflected. See, the first methyl group is being reflected over here, and this is the original molecule. Assume there is a mirror here, and the mirror image and original molecule appears to be similar. Again, the mirror image, if you see, if I pass or bisect the plane, I get methyl group that is being reflected over here, which means these are superimposable. Therefore, cis 1, 2 dimethyl cyclobutane is assumed to be a achiral molecule, not a chiral molecule. We will move on to the trans cis 1, 2 dimethyl butane. So, this is trans position. You see the methyl groups are present in trans positions, both in original molecule as well as the mirror image molecule, it is present in trans position. So, if I pass a plane over this trans molecule, the image that is present is not going to get reflected over here. See the observation, here proton is present, whereas here methyl group is present. And similarly, for the mirror image, the methyl group is present here and here the proton is present. Able to get the difference now? So, it does not have a plane of symmetry. Actually, this trans 1, 2 dimethyl cyclobutane does not have a plane of symmetry. So, we conclude from this example that cis 1, 2 dimethyl cyclobutane is a achiral molecule, whereas trans 1, 2 dimethyl cyclobutane is a chiral molecule. So, how do you get a chiral position here? see this carbon. This carbon has a methyl group and a proton group, and you have a CH2 group here, and you have a carbon connected with H and methyl group. So, this carbon is a chiral carbon. It is being surrounded with 4 atoms, methyl atom, proton atom and CH2 methylene atom, and here CH3 connected with H atom. So, similarly here you can see the carbon having 4 bondets, carbon having proton bond, then methyl bond and connected to CH3H bond, and here you have the methylene bond. So, we name 1,2 trans 1,2 dimethyl cyclobutane as a chiral molecule. Hope so, these examples provide you the difference between chiral and achiral. Let us explain what is stereogenic center. A stereogenic center is one where when we interchange any two group of an atom which produces a stereoisomer. For example, we take a stereogenic center being bonded with 4 different atoms. When I interchange these two groups, like if I place a bromine here and a Cl here, if I interchange, again we produce a chiral molecule. If you are able to interchange the group which result in a stereoisomer, then we name it as stereogenic center. And one more example is 3-bromohexane. Even here when you replace the ethyl group and propyl group, you get again a stereogenic center. So, what is a stereogenic center is one where when we interchange the group, we get again a stereoisomer. Similarly, a non-stereogenic center is one on which the interchange of the substituent does not result in producing a stereoisomer. Let us discuss how symmetry elements play important role in chirality. In order to discuss about this chirality and symmetry, first we will define what is symmetry. Symmetry is a plane, line or a point in which through an object about which you bring a rotation, reflection or inversion leaves the object indistinguishable from the original one. And symmetry operation is nothing but the action that is carried out on a molecule. After doing that action, whenever you bring the original molecule, then you perform a symmetry operation. There are various elements of symmetry. Number one, proper axis of symmetry, plane of symmetry, center of symmetry, and rotation reflection axis. So, one by one, we will see proper axis of symmetry. A compound has a simple axis of symmetry if rotation about an imaginary axis passing on it, the molecule can be converted into identical in all respects. Example is chloroform. So, in chloroform, you have a CHCl3 formula, CHCl3, and if I pass an axis here and if I rotate this molecule, proper axis of rotation, if I rotate it to 120 degrees, I will get the identical molecule. So, 360 divided by 120 is 3. So, I get C3 axis for chloroform molecule, which means if I rotate this molecule through 120 degrees, I get the identical molecule, and it is always represented as C integer n. N is number of degrees you rotate the molecule. So, now let us move on to plane of symmetry. So, plane of symmetry, as we have seen already in chiral as well as achiral property, plane of symmetry is divides the object in such a way that the point on one side of the plane is equivalent to the point on the other side when you reflect the molecule through the plane. So, this is the molecule we take and we bisect the molecule or divide the molecule. We get the reflection. This is in the case of cis form, whereas in the trans form, the methyl group will be present here. So, that will be a achiral molecule, whereas over this molecule, the plane of symmetry is nothing but when you bisect a molecule, you get the reflection of the group present over here. Next element of symmetry is center or point of symmetry. We take here the 2R3S dibromobutane as the example. A center of symmetry is any point in space such that any group on the molecule can be reflected back through that point an equal distance but opposite direction, and an equivalent group is found. For example, if I take this molecule this is the center of the molecule, and if I target any group, suppose I project bromine group, and through this projection, if I extend this projection to equal distance in opposite direction with equidistant, I get a bromine molecule. So, similarly, if I attempt here for methyl, I take the methyl group and I extend the projection to center and then extend it in opposite direction with equal distance, I get the same molecule in the opposite side. Similarly, for proton H atom, this is H atom, if I project it or I draw a line to the center and with the same amount of equidistant I draw in opposite direction, I end up with one proton. So, a center of symmetry is any point in space such that any group, if you take methyl, bromine or proton, it can be reflected. So, if I take any three groups, that could be reflected over here in opposite direction with equivalent distance. So, this is called as center of symmetry or otherwise point of symmetry. Why to say this axis of symmetry or plane of symmetry or center of symmetry or rotation reflection axis? Rotation reflection axis we are yet to complete. So, what is rotation reflection axis? It has two functions. One is we need to perform rotation, the other one is reflection. So, it is represented as S1 operation. It involves two operations, C1 and sigma. C1 does not change the molecule. C1 is nothing but 360 degree. It is going to give an identity E rotation, and sigma is reflection. Example is alpha truxylic acid. So, here I take this molecule and we rotate to 180 degree. So, upon doing this rotation, you could see the proton has come down here and the COH group has gone up. Similarly, the phenyl group has come down and proton has gone over here. Same thing, COH group has come down here and the proton has gone above. So, this is after performing 180 degree rotation. So, this is one operation. After this rotation, we go for reflection, just perpendicular to the axis of rotation. After doing reflection, if you get the same molecule, then it is called rotation reflection axis. So, I explain again, we take alpha truxylic acid, we rotate this to 180 degree, we get a different molecule, both are not same. You do a reflection action over it, and after performing this, you get a molecule, you end up with a molecule which is similar to your starting material, which means this is known as rotation reflection axis. So, how do we connect all this symmetry and chirality is? In order to have chirality, it should lack of certain symmetry operations. So, what kind of symmetry operations should get lacked, or it should not have a plane of symmetry, or it should not have an inversion symmetry? If both the symmetries are absent, then we could say that molecule possesses chiral property. Or I can say a molecule could be achiral if it has a plane of symmetry and inversion of symmetry. So, finally, we conclude what are the needs for chirality. The carbon should bear an sp3 hybridized one with a regular tetrahedron structure, or it could be a pyramidal atom with three ligands. We consider lone pair as one more ligand. So, need not be a tetrahedral structure, it could even be a pyramidal structure. And asymmetric, as I told, asymmetric is nothing but a center which has got four substituent linked together. And one more point is, it should lack, or it should does not possess any element of symmetry, but rotational axis alone is permitted. And the final criteria for chirality is, it should rotate the plane polarized light in equal magnitude, but in opposite direction. There should be one stereogenic center. If it has more than one stereogenic center, again it would become a achiral molecule. So, now let us move on to dissymmetry and asymmetric. Well, you would be noted what is asymmetric. So, I will explain what is dissymmetry. So, when a molecule possesses a simple axis of symmetry, so we told the presence of chirality with respect to element of symmetry is having at least rotational axis of symmetry. If such a molecule having a simple axis of symmetry, then that molecule is considered to be a dissymmetric molecule. Example is 1,2-dichlorocyclopropane. So, I take cyclopropane and 1,2 position, 1,2-dichlorocyclopropane. So, this is cis. We move on to trans, 1,2-dicyclopropane. So, over this if I pass axis of symmetry, see if I pass an axis of symmetry, I get C3 axis. So, this molecule is said to be dissymmetric. So, any cyclopropane if you take cis cyclopropane, dichloros, this has got C2 operation and C3 operation. It has got C2 as well as C3 operation. So, this trans dicyclopropane is supposed to be a dissymmetric one because it has got axis of rotation. So, finally, we have defined what is dissymmetry. The conclusion from symmetry operations are, a molecule will be chiral if it has n-fold axis of symmetry. A molecule will be chiral if it lacks plane of symmetry and center of symmetry. Now, let us move on in defining enantiomers. What are enantiomers? We defined what is chiral molecule. A chiral molecule will have 4 different connected atoms, and if you place a mirror over it, you get a mirror image of that. So, these 2 pairs form the enantiomers. So, a chiral molecule on placing over a mirror, you get mirror image of that original molecule. These two pairs are known as enantiomers. Regarding the properties of enantiomers, they have similar physical properties, like they have the boiling points, melting points, and pKa values. All these values are to be similar, and hence they show same physical properties. With respect to optical activity, they rotate the plane polarized light in equal magnitude but in opposite direction, and they do get different configuration, like one isomer will be in R configuration, the other isomer will be present in S configuration. Example is, we take carbon. This is the structure of carbon. See, this carbon, I told you R configuration and S configuration. So, specialty in knowing this carbon is, the R configuration has got a spearmint smell odor, whereas this S configuration has got a caraway seed smell, which means the receptor cell neurons of our nose are responsible in giving different orders for the same structure of molecule, but both the structures have got same molecular formula. They differ only in the configuration. One is present in R configuration, the other is present in S configuration. So, this is to know about the enantiomers are responsible for many factors. For example, one more case study that we need to discuss regarding enantiomers are biological activity of enantiomers, which play a major role in drug designing. Thalidomide is the best example to explain the properties of enantiomers. So, in late 1950s, the drug was introduced as a sedative for pregnant women, and more than 50% of women in Western countries have used that medicine. So, later on they found the women, those who have taken this medicine, produced babies with deformities in their limbs, where when they analyzed what could be the severe problem between the drug activity, and finally, they came to a situation, the isomers play important role, or enantiomers play important role in drug activity of thalidomide. where the plus form of the thalidomide has been a sedative effect, whereas the R form has produced the deformities in limbs among the birth babies. So, this is a very important factor to know about the enantiomeric properties. On summary of this discussion, we finally conclude the difference between chiral and achiral, and what is symmetry, what are symmetry operations, and how symmetry operations play role in determining the chirality, and what are enantiomers, what is the significance in knowing the properties of enantiomers. Questions: identify the following as chiral or achiral: pair of gloves, pair of socks, and what is center of symmetry, what is axis of symmetry in cyclohexane and substituted cyclohexane, that is 1-methyl cyclohexane. We come to the end of the session. Thank you.